on my way now.
Well, welcome back to another video here. We are back in Cape Breton of all places, but this time not for the tiny home, unfortunately.
We will have an update on that later in the video, yep. But today it's a beautiful day. We've actually had a series of really, really terrible weather, not today. So today we are in a place that so many of you have told us to come to. We have spent a little bit of time here in the past, but haven't really filmed it. We did eat a meal here last year. It's one of the places we consider to be a very, very cute town here in Nova Scotia, except it's actually a village. It's called Baddeck.
So we're here right now on one of the main wharfs. I think we're very close to the yacht club. You can see Anna admiring the view. The lake here is actually part of the ocean. This is the Bredor Lakes. It's smack dab. We are right in the middle of Cape Breton. It's one of the most beautiful locations. It's so peaceful here. The water's calming and there's greenery all around. There's also a lighthouse off in the distance too.
I see you here dreaming of our future yacht, perhaps?
Yeah, do you like this one? I kind of like the catamaran in the back. We could sail around the world. We could change over to a sailing channel.
Do you like it?
You into it?
You're going to need some money for that.
You might need some money for that. So if you want to support our channel, see it become a sailing channel. Just kidding. We're not going to become... Well, who knows? You never know what will happen in the future, but there are no plans to become a sailing channel. However, a lot of you guys do ask how you can support our channel. There's two really big main ways. One is our Patreon account. I think it's like for as little as $3 a month, you can support us. And then there's also the join button, which is right down there.
How about that for a segue, huh? But on a more serious note, let's go take a look at this catamaran down here. It's quite something.
Can you imagine having that and sailing around, coming to Baddeck? I think people really like it because you're right in the middle of the Bredor Lakes. But there is something really appealing about getting in a boat and just being able to go wherever you want.
Okay, so speaking of being able to go wherever you want, we do have a bit of exciting news. Now, we haven't been able to travel outside the province because of this whole pandemic. We're all over that, aren't we? Well, dose number two is happening for us. It's very soon.
Yeah, in a couple of days, so that's super exciting.
Yes.
Obviously, that means in a few weeks, we're technically able to travel again. A lot of countries are opening up to people
that's
with
crazy.
Both doses.
So that's super some exciting. Of you might remember, originally we were scheduled for September 1st to get dose number two. It's just the way it worked here in Canada. And we were crossing our fingers and toes and everything we could that with the hope that it would be earlier. And
yeah,
now,
and now it's moved up like 8 or 9 weeks, something like that. So that's
crazy.
So exciting. But Jay, you're probably wondering, does that mean we're just going to like hop on a plane and go somewhere? No, we have so much planned for Nova Scotia this summer. We have the tiny house, obviously.
Yes.
That's going to be ready at some point. We will update you in a second about that. And, you know, we just have lots of cool stuff planned throughout the summer.
I think it's going to be somewhere still around September for those of you that are wondering, but we can't wait to get back on the road. So for those of you that are wondering where Baddeck is, it's very much in the middle of Cape Breton, towards the bottom of the Cabot Trail. Now, if you're planning to do the Cabot Trail, and if you're not planning to do it, you should. You're going to land in Baddeck. It's one of the best little villages, most charming little towns that we have here. You're gonna wanna stop in this place.
All right, it looks like someone made some friends here.
Yes, they're lovely, lovely people. This is Mabel and Alexander Graham Bell. You might recognize the name, of course, Alexander Graham Bell, the very, very famous inventor. These guys actually lived here in the summertime, so there is a museum here you can go visit, find out all the stuff he invented. I hear it's very, very interesting.
Well, there is one big one he invented.
The telephone.
Did you guys know that? The telephone was invented here in Nova Scotia by this guy. So we just came over to the main part of the village. It's only like a 30-second walk from the water. And now you might be able to tell why this place is so appealing. There's all these local shops, boutiques, restaurants. It's very appealing for tourists.
Yeah, and normally not in a pandemic time. It is packed with people.
Oh, yeah.
It's often hard to find parking, so come early.
Yes, come very early.
By the way, last summer we did a whole series on where to eat in Cape Breton. We came to this place here. It's called the Telegraph House. We had the most amazing meal sitting out on that patio. We will link the video up here so you can go watch it because it was so delicious.
Yeah, it was one of our faves.
Yeah.
So we have now come over to Inverary Resort to this restaurant called Lakeside. And how about this location? We're right here on the water. You can see the beautiful bay. And of course we have a craft beer and we ordered some food. If we take a look at this down here, we got some fish and chips. This is one portion and we're gonna split this and well, see what it's all about.
Okay, I'm gonna start on the fries. They look delicious. They're like hand cut. Drop them one over here. Try in the ketchup. good.
All right. Well, it's a good sign if we got good fries.
Also some coleslaw here, but it looks really interesting.
It does, doesn't it?
I'm trying to figure out if that's like kale in there. I'm not sure. There's a really unique taste to it, and I can't pinpoint what it is.
All right, time for the main attraction. It's crispy, golden-looking haddock. I love that there's tartar sauce on the bottom. It's just at the base, so usually tartar sauce is on the side. Let's see how this is going to be. Oh, yeah. Oh, I just... melts right in your mouth. The tartar sauce is like a little citrusy. The fish is crunchy. There's herbs, there's spices. I have a lot of respect for this fish. It probably came from the bay right here. It's very, very delicious. I'm very curious if Anna is going to like this. So you guys know, if you follow us on our adventures, she normally doesn't eat fish, but from time to time, she will try white fish, especially like a haddock or something like this, if it's fresh. So let's test her.
I have to say, this looks maybe quite a bit different than what you traditionally see for fish and chips. They're often like beer battered and like quite, I guess, more fried looking on the outside.
Yeah,
this almost looks a little...
pan fried and flash
fried? Dare I say like healthier?
It does.
It's really nice on the outside. Whatever they do for the batter looks really lovely. And it's got some, I think Trevor said, some herbs in it. Like you can see it there.
It's a beautiful looking fish.
I'm nervous. Always a little bit nervous before eating fish because I just can't handle even a slight bit of fishiness. So let's see. No, it's really, really delicious. Like Trevor said, the tartar sauce is excellent. It's really, really good. But the batter's great as well. I really like this. I definitely think I prefer it to like the really, really greasy kind. Like it's just nice and light and really delicious.
Well, this place is absolutely awesome.
It is. We just finished eating. Now we're down here on the water. I see some kayaks.
Ooh, what are you thinking?
I'm wondering if we can rent one and take it out there.
So we actually know you can rent these. If you're wondering what the cost is, it's $10 an hour for a single, and there's one double here that's about 15. We're gonna take that one out in a few minutes. I also noticed though earlier, some guys took out some Sea-Doos and their stand-up paddle boards as well, all at this resort. It's really cool. It's just steps away from where we just had lunch. All right, we made it in. We have the GoPro on. How's that water, by the way?
It's a little chilly, so hopefully we don't fall in.
Yes, and let's not drop the camera, but this is beautiful, you guys. Look at that. Yeah, this place is so serene. It's so beautiful. As you're just paddling out here, right now the wind's just taking us, so we're in the bay. The wind's coming off kind of the open lake there. You can see there's boats, docks. I can't believe this is right in the middle of Baddeck. You could walk here from the village.
Right, we've made it across whatever this is called, a bay or the lake or...
Channel?
The channel, yeah. It was a little bit rocky on the way over, a little bit wavy, but we made it to the better part right now. At the beginning, my butt was very dry here in the front, and Trevor was getting wet quite early on, but now I can report that my butt is quite wet.
I can tell you that I am team wet butt back here.
Yes. Thankfully, we were smart and brought extra pants with us, or extra shorts, another pair of shorts with us. So.
Also, why am I the one doing all the work right now?
I'm just gonna sit here and be lazy.
So now we docked up on this little private island, yes. Sort of like a beach, huh?
Hopefully you guys can hear us. It's very, very windy, and we're switched over to the GoPro, which does not have a wind buff, so hopefully you can hear
us. We have a wind protector, and this is gonna be the test. If you can't hear anything, we'll put words on the screen, but check this out. So Baddeck is just kind of behind us here. You can see the little private beach we're on, and then where we just rented was kind of way over that way, somewhere, right about there.
So let us know in the comments if you know of another place where you can rent a kayak, kayak for like maybe 15 minutes and come to your own private beach. I think that's pretty special.
Yeah, that's pretty special.
Yeah.
I mean, this beach is small though.
Yeah, but it's super cute. I mean, there's no one else here, so it doesn't really matter.
No, look, and again, I'll show you guys. So yeah, it stretches all the way up there, but this is really nice given that it's so close to where we just came from.
Yeah.
All right, so no trip is complete without coming over to Big Spruce. Right now we're about 10 minutes outside of Baddeck to this gorgeous property. Take a look, you can see behind me the Brador Lakes, and the setting here, it's on a hill, it's green, there's a big building. Sometimes there's live music here. And there's food as well. Not today, we're kind of early, but sometimes there is food, just so you know. We're big craft beer fans. I got a Pilsner, let's give it a quick try. Light and refreshing, does the trick on this summer day.
So you guys might remember that a few weeks ago we were in Cape Breton, but it was phase one of reopening here in Nova Scotia, so we weren't allowed to visit anyone, which was really, really weird, because as you guys know, Trevor's parents live here. So we've been up here for a few days now, but the weather has been just terrible. It's been cold, it's been rainy. So happy to finally be out on a nice day, and look who came to join us. It's Trevor's parents, Bill and Karen.
Hi.
Bill, Karen. They're having a beer with us.
Yeah.
Still feels weird in this COVID world, doesn't it?
It does.
All right, it's time to give you guys an update on our tiny home. For those of you that have been following along, you know now that we bought a tiny home. We know where it's going to go. There's just one problem. We're hitting some delays.
I think that's pretty normal for anything that is under construction, especially for these times, because everybody seems to be building stuff, so supplies are in short demand.
Yes.
But it's right now a few weeks behind schedule, I guess, but I just expect it to be a few more weeks beyond that.
The problem now at the moment, I think the windows are delayed, so obviously we need windows. So we don't know when we're going to get back to filming the actual tiny home yet. Hopefully later in the summer, but we promise it will happen as soon as we can make it happen. I know we keep getting a lot of questions from you guys about that. So until then, we're going to be exploring more of Cape Breton, more of Nova Scotia, and then we'll hop back into that tiny home series. And then hopefully after that, that's my plane.
We take off in an airplane. So we are back at Trevor's parents' place. And speaking of the tiny house, since we were just talking about it, we've been getting so much stuff shipped here. This actually is like a tiny minuscule part of all the boxes that we've had shipped here. There's a bunch upstairs, there's a bunch all over the place, I'm sorry.
So we think this box is full of a bunch of other boxes.
Maybe decorative stuff? I'm not really sure. So there's like stuff from IKEA down here.
These are chairs.
Chairs.
Hard to believe that this box is a chair. But they're barstool chairs.
Barstools, yeah. I don't even remember everything we bought. We bought so much stuff.
Oh, all right, it's gonna be like Christmas.
It is.
What even is this?
It's bubble wrap!
Look at all the bubbles we get to pop. Who else likes to do that? Oh wow, look at that.
Boxes.
It's a
boxes.
Giant box and little boxes.
Oh, there's a
basket for blankets.
A basket? That's cute.
This is totally like Christmas.
Mm-hmm. But everything else is in a box like this.
What do we think that is?
No, but it's super bubble wrapped. Just figured out what it is. It's a lamp that we ordered. Very, very cute. So obviously the light bulb would go in there. And
yeah, we'll probably hang this.
No, I don't think we'd hang
it. Or we just put it maybe in one of the windows.
Yeah, probably in one of the windows. Some mood lighting, some evening lighting, so it's not like super bright in the nighttime. But yeah, I like it.
So this is the stage we're at right now. It's kind of fun because we are looking for things like, this is gonna be like a little coat hanger, probably right when you come in the door. So we are getting excited about everything, but it's just too bad that there's a delay again on the tiny house in general. What do you got over there? You got another one?
I believe it's a plant. One sec, everything's very, very well wrapped up, which is great because it means it's not gonna break, but let's see if I can actually get into this.
So before anyone gets on us about real plants, we're not gonna be living there. This needs to be low maintenance.
Yeah, it'd be impossible to have an actual live plant just because who's gonna feed it, but.
Not us.
That's cute.
I like
it. Two of those, two on the wall.
So obviously we'll show these guys a lot more of this once we get into, when the tiny home's ready.
Yeah, I can't wait to show it to you as we like actually legitimately are inside the tiny house and we're really decorating it. Oh, I can't wait.
So we're gonna leave you guys here. We're gonna open the rest of these boxes. There are more sets of boxes in different places.
Loads of boxes.
In my parents' house. Plus we're starting to barbecue upstairs. We're trying to, you know, spend time with my family. It's been the first time in almost a year. That's still so strange.
Yeah, 8 or 9 months, something like that.
Well, because of this COVID stuff, if you're watching in the future and you're like, why? You know, COVID. So here we are. But if you enjoyed the video today, make sure to share it with your friends. Click on the like button. That really helps us out. I'm Trevor and this is Anna. We are the delightful travelers, in case you don't know and you got this far. So,
and good on you if you got this far and had no idea who we are. Good job. Congratulations.
I mean, that'd be pretty cool. If you did, you definitely want to hit subscribe because we do this every Sunday. And normally we're on the road traveling around the world. We've been exploring our home province of Nova Scotia and having a blast for the last year.
In a couple months, we will be back on the road. Somewhere exciting.
Oh man, that's so weird to even think about, but yeah. Can't wait.
All right, guys, that's it.
From Cape Breton, wishing you delightful travels.
See you soon.